Hi, I'm Kat Matlock, founder of Freedom of Movement Bodyworks. I'm a trigger point therapist since 1993, and I specialize in the reduction and elimination of chronic pain. And this is Freedom from Restless Leg Syndrome. We're going to use balls leaning against the wall to trap the trigger points of the gluteus medius against the wall to just soothe them and release them so that you can sleep well. When working on your own trigger points at home, you can use a variety of sizes and density of balls to shift the amount of pressure. Almost everybody has a tennis ball, so that's an easy one to have. I like to use a handball because it's a little bit smaller, so it can get in some other deeper places, and it's got a little more give. And then a high bounce ball is very hard, so when you really need to get more pressure, you can use this ball. But really, any of these balls will do the trick. To roll the three main trigger points in the gluteus medius muscle, which cause restless leg syndrome, begin by placing the back of your hand on your sacrum, and then place the ball just outside of the hand into the soft tissue on the pelvis next to the sacrum. Now, keep the ball there, relax your other arm, and lean against the ball on the wall. Wiggle around a little bit, move around a little bit until you find just the right point, and you'll know when you find it. Pause, breathe, relax. If the pressure is too intense, step your feet a little closer to the wall. If you want more pressure, step your feet further away from the wall, and that will lean more of your body weight into the wall. After a few breaths on that point, or when you feel it release, then take your hand, move the ball up and over just a little bit to the top of the pelvis, and then lean back against the wall and roll around until you find that second point. It'll be right at the top of the pelvis. Pause, breathe, relax. See if you can feel the point lessen in intensity. After a few breaths and relaxing, just move the ball out another inch or so and slightly down as following that curve of the pelvis, and then bring your bum back to the wall. Roll around a little bit. See if you can find that third spot. And then when you do, pause, sink, relax, and breathe. Take a few breaths, allowing the trigger point to soften. And then when it releases, or if you've taken 4 or 5 breaths, then you just lean away from the wall, move the ball, and then stretch the muscle. You can put the ball down. Stretch the muscle by bringing your hands to the wall. Step back, bend both knees. Cross the ankle of the foot, the side that you just worked. Cross that ankle over the top of the knee. Bend the standing leg knee and sit down into it. The more you bend the standing leg, the more stretch you'll feel in the gluteus muscles. Just breathe a few breaths here and then stand up. And now that we've shown you how to release the right side, you want to always do both sides in your practice. So take a moment and release the left side against the wall. The muscle that creates restless leg syndrome is called gluteus medius. And gluteus medius lives along the top of the pelvis and then attaches into the side of the femur right here in the greater trochanter. So it fills this whole side of the pelvis in here. It lifts the leg back in extension and lifts the leg out to the side in what's called abduction. And this muscle, when it gets loaded with trigger points, will cause restless leg syndrome. When you lay down, you feel like your legs can't relax. So the three main trigger points that gluteus medius can harbor are one right next to the sacrum, and then following the top of the pelvis to trigger point number 2, and then following down a little bit to trigger point number 3. So here on the skeleton, we can see the shape of the pelvis. The tops of the pelvis are shaped similar to the tops of a heart. And here's the sacrum right in the center. And the gluteus medius point number 1 is right here in that corner, next to the sacrum, near this bony prominence here on the pelvis, and right at the top. And then the gluteus medius point number 2 is just up a little higher and over to the side. And then gluteus medius point number 3 is a little further out on the side. And eradicating these points in the gluteus medius will take care of your restless leg syndrome. In my experience as a trigger point therapist, I have come to the understanding that restless leg syndrome is caused by trigger points in the gluteus medius muscle. The gluteus medius muscle can harbor trigger points, and then when you go to lay down at night to go to sleep, the trigger points become irritated and activated, and the legs will start moving and kicking. It'll just feel like you have a lot of tension in your legs and they need to move. So I've had a lot of success in helping folks to get rid of their restless leg syndrome by not only working on them, but teaching them how to work on themselves. So at night, before you go to bed, if you do this short practice, which should just take about a minute or two, you'll find that perhaps you can sleep through the night without any restless leg symptoms at all.